Mina, ohayo gozaimasu. JesusFreakinGamer here. We're finally out of the book of Samuel and into the book of the Kings. The end of David's life draws near. The beginning of the race, as if it's a different race of people. The lineage, I should say, of the kings is about to start, starting with King David's son, Solomon. That's starting up very soon. Now I'm going to focus on that in chapter 1. In fact, I'm not even sure if that... No, that does appear in chapter 1. I was wrong. But that's not what I'm going to be focusing on first. I'm going to focus on the believability of certain passages of the Bible. And this is very simple, but I think it illustrates the point very well. So I'm going to dive right in. It's 1 Kings chapter 1, starting in verse 1. Now King David was old, advanced in years, and they put covers on him, but he could not get warm. Therefore his servants said to him, "Let a young woman, a virgin, be sought for our lord the king, and let her stand before the king, and let her care for him, and let her lie in your bosom, that our lord the king may be warm." So they sought for a lovely young woman throughout all the territory of Israel, and found Abishag the Shunammite, and brought her to the king. The young woman was very lovely, and she cared for the king, and served him, but the king did not know her. In modern English, that means the king did not have sex with her. Now, the reason I think this is an excellent example of certain passages in the Bible, do we believe them, do we not believe them? I guess the more obvious passages would be, you know, the supernatural stuff. The miracles Moses did, the miracles Jesus did, do we believe them or not? Is that possible or not? On a more natural, normalistic level, let's just be frank for a minute. I'm very frank and I'm very honest. How many guys could sleep with a beautiful young woman, and because the purpose was to get King David warm, I'm guessing, I could be wrong, but I'm guessing there's a strong possibility that they both slept together naked and she pressed his body against him so that her body warmth would warm him up, whereas cloths and sheets couldn't do it. Another human body could. So the implication that I'm getting from that is that she was not only sleeping next to him, right next to him, but she was actually pressing her naked body against him. And for a man to not have sex with a beautiful young woman sleeping naked on top of him, that stretches my suspension of belief, I think is the proper term. That stretches my ability to believe that story. Like, wait, are you serious? Really? I wouldn't doubt that this was thrown in the Bible because of the previously recorded mistake. And because he made that mistake and the Bible was honest about it, that lends credibility to the fact that the Bible's probably telling the truth on this point. But just honestly, is that easy to believe? No. Being completely honest and open with you guys here, that doesn't sound within the realm of possibility to me as a man. So, will we choose to believe the Bible or not? I choose to believe the Bible because I believe it's the Word of God. I mentioned logically how it makes sense considering the story the Bible passed on earlier. But some things in the Bible are hard to believe. For me, and I think for most guys, if they think about it, this would be one of those things where it's like, do I really believe that? And that does, on a level, boil down to your faith in the Bible. Do you believe it's the Word of God or not? Do you believe it is trustworthy or not? It's a simple example, maybe even silly, but I just think it's a great time to look at the Bible and say, do we really believe what this book is telling us? Is this really telling us the truth? And I will say, yes, I believe it is. I believe it's absolutely true. I believe it's the Word of God. I don't believe it's lying to me. Even in something as far-fetched as this. So hopefully this will encourage people to think a little bit more serious about taking the Bible seriously on a simpler level, you know, whether it's trustworthy or not. And I've probably made myself look like the biggest pervert in the world just being completely honest with you guys, because I try to do that. I want you guys to know who I am, and I just want to be completely crystal clear, like transparently honest with you guys. And if that makes me look like something like a pervert, then so be it. I've been honest with you guys at the very least. Thank you guys very much for this video. I love you. Not like that. And God bless.